Looking out of the balcony at her Noida home, Captain Zoya Agarwal looks at her one-year-old momentous feet with a large sip of coffee. There's not a single memory that she wants to forget in the chill of January in New Delhi. Believe it or not, but it's been one whole year since Air India took first all-women flight over the North Pole on the world's longest air route, that is between San Francisco and Bengaluru. Its commander was a lady on your screen. In the middle of COVID-induced pandemic, Zoya and many aviators like her fearlessly flew in the service of India. Sometimes ferrying the passengers under Vande Bharat mission, other times bringing COVID medical essential supplies over cargo airplanes from various countries including China. As the all-women flight completes 1 year and marks its celebration, the new Indian speaks to Zoya at her Noida home.
I think this flight has sort of proven like a beacon of inspiration, not only for a woman or a young girl who wants to become a pilot. I think it's become sort of a hope for all our Bharat ki betis, Desh ki betis, because today they see a normal girl, a dreamer like an 8-year-old Zoya, who by God's grace has gone through her journey and emerged on the other side, being the youngest woman in 2013 to fly the Boeing 777, thereafter being the first one to fly over the North Pole.
1 year after the non-stop all-women flight between Bengaluru and San Francisco, women like Air India pilot Zoya Agarwal are still taking India to new heights. Even in such turbulent time of COVID, they are bringing families closer to each other.
Just less than 20 days ago, Zoya and her colleagues, pilots R. Someshwar, Sandeep Mukhedar and Abhay Agarwal, achieved another feat when they took Air India Boeing 777 over the gigantic Hindu Kush range to reach the US. As a result, the flying time between New Delhi and New York is now going to be less than 16 hours, even if it means flying over the towering mountains. This has now reduced carbon footprint and time both.
It is our duty to go and get our citizens from wherever they were. They needed to be reunited with their families, with their loved ones, and we had to do that. And I'm really, really happy that our government launched a mission of Vande Bharat. As it turned out, it was not planned. It just so happened that me and my crew became the first ones to fly from Toronto to Delhi when we were flying back. And this is the highest airspace where you can fly in the world, and it's extremely critical because the terrain is extremely high, and there are a lot of challenges which surround that particular terrain. Of course, there is a challenge, but there's always the safety norms that we as an airline, we always make sure that we cater to, because safety for our passengers, for everyone around us is paramount. Grimlook at the airports when I would go to operate the cargo flights. Initially, we started by carrying supplies from China, the medical kits and so on and so forth. The entire airport was empty, so much so that the electricity was shut down. Everything, there would be one elevator functioning in one side of the airport. And that is something, you're not geared up. The women leaders, the change makers, the path breakers of tomorrow, and they are going to take the world by the storm and do such wonderful things and break and shatter the glass ceilings. And I am waiting for that day when the world is going to be so much of a better place and a happier, satisfied place, because we'll actually give wings to our children to dream and achieve what they really want to do and not what we want them to do. I read a few lines and I'll repeat those lines. And these lines are dedicated to every single Bharat ki beti who's watching out there. Bharat ki betiyan nahi kam kisi se. Toofa ya aandhi nahi dar kisi se. Aakash mein likha hai ek sandesha. Bharat ki jai ho, vijay ho hamesha. Aage badhte rahiye, udte rahiye. नमस्कार, जय हिंद।
For more such fine stories and video reports from field, subscribe to our channel, The New Indian.